I'm Dana from Pop Gang, and I'm here with Aria Rostami. And so, coming out soon is your dual EP, or?
Yeah, so it's two EPs. One I recorded last year, one I recorded this year. And they're being released together on Crash Cymbals.
Decades and Peter?
Decades and Peter are the name. So Peter is the one I did last year. So I wrote that after my friend died. That album has this joy to it. Because it's more of like this appreciation of his life. But with that joy also has these ups and downs and these swells. Just exploring loss, but not in a negative way. Exploring loss actually in a positive way. Because when there's a bookend, it allows you to look at what's happened and appreciate that it's even happened because now it's over. And then actually Coven, which is the album that's not released yet, that's gonna be released next year, is a sci-fi soundtrack for a film that doesn't exist. It's really actually about the destruction of humans altogether. Humans disappear and life goes on. Decades is in the attempts to make it completely different is completely like devoid of like concept. I usually like to make conceptual art, but with Decades I was like, I don't want any concept, I don't want any like meaning behind it, I just want it to be like sound based. Decades, from the beginning I knew I was gonna do it that. I knew everything's gonna be the DE, partly because, not that I have like extreme synesthesia, but I do have some association with letters and colors, and D is purple, and it's like an eggplant purple, and I wanted that the vibe of that color to be throughout the album. Peter, so my friend who passed away, his name was Sean, but it's the reason I picked Peter over other names is, one, the way it looks. I was in a band with Sean called Fee, F-E-I-E, and that was, we named it that specifically for the way Fee looks, so lowercase F-E-I-E. And then Peter kind of has the same curves, P-E-T-E. That's where Peter comes from. Decades. Coven is named after a fictional movie. So Coven is based on a fictional soundtrack for a fictional movie. And there's a movie called American Movie, which is a mockumentary where they're trying to make a horror film. And the film is called Coven. So there is some humor in that. You may not be able to see it here, or you may not be able to see it in my music per se, but I do want to convey some humor, because I think humor is a little important. Like, you don't want to be completely devoid of humor. So, Cove, and then the first track is called Hoth, which is an obvious Star Wars reference. The last song is Yellowknife Bay, which is not based on the city in Canada. It's actually, Yellowknife Bay is where the Mars rover landed. And the song itself kind of feels like a Martian sandstorm. It's just constant energy. It's like an ambient song, constant pushing energy, and it's the texture is constant also. Everything's being maxed out to be like pushing energy.
It's for your upcoming double EP. What are three things that you want listeners to do
That's interesting, especially since it's two different works. Somebody once asked me what they would want an audience to do while they're listening to music, and I told them have sex, but I don't necessarily mean that in like a douchey way. I know that sounds really douchey, but no, I don't make party music. I don't really make social music. So I think something that you do alone or with one other person would be appropriate.
I have sex though.
I think because sex is very personal and sensual. Sex, death, eating. Three really personal things.
Eat, die, and procreate music.
Yeah, those are that's as basic as it gets. That's as basic as it gets. It's your solitary experience. I make art that's basically for solitary experiences.
So, when are we to expect the dual EP release?
I don't have a date yet. It's gonna be September. Coven will come out early next year, and then I'm working on another album right now. So, I'm almost done with it, actually. So,
thank you, Aria, for your time.
That's not good.
And we hope to talk to you again.
Yeah, bye.